Hey guys, welcome back to the Doomcast channel. I just want to share some life lessons I've learned with some younger people and really get this discussion going. One of the things I think that's really important for young people to understand is that you have to be really careful who you trust. Just because somebody's being nice to you doesn't mean that there's somebody you can really trust. One of the big mistakes that young people make, and one of the big mistakes that I made as a young person, is that I gave away my trust too easily. You know, I trusted the wrong people. I didn't follow my instinct. A lot of times when you meet a person, you get an instinct about a person, it's usually accurate. And where we go wrong is when we try to ignore that instinct about a person, and we try to justify some of the red flags, some of the behaviors that they do, simply because the person is nice to us, and maybe we like the person, or maybe the person is attractive, or whatever. We sort of ignore all these red flags because, you know, we like this person. And that's a big mistake. One, you got to make sure people earn your trust. If you're a young person, make sure people earn your trust. Don't be so quick to trust people who are simply nice to you or do a couple good things for you, because you don't know what type of ulterior motive they really have. You don't know what type of agenda they're really working with. And really, you got to work with a protocol of you can't really trust people until they earn your trust. Some people go the opposite way. They trust everybody until they have a reason not to. You really can't afford to do that, because you can get yourself into a lot of big problems by just simply trusting people until they give you a reason not to. The reason why you don't want to do that is because if you like a person, you might start to ignore the red flags. And that's the thing, you know. If people lie to you, even little lies, that's indicative of a bigger problem. They may start to tell them bigger lies later on. Another thing is, you know, some people will talk about certain individuals. I'm not saying you should judge somebody based off of what somebody else says, but you should always just keep it in your head. You know, if you're warned about a certain person by somebody that you trust, at least keep that in your head. Don't just ignore things. Be very careful who you trust, because that can change your life. Simply being around the wrong person at the wrong time can destroy your life. Even if you're not doing anything, a bad person could talk you into doing something you normally wouldn't do, or you can simply just be around. Be in a car when somebody goes to a liquor store and robs it or something, and you can look at some serious times, some serious problems, just by being around a person who's doing something negative. Just by association, authorities may figure, hey, you're always around this person, so maybe you are involved with this. If the person starts to sell drugs or whatever, the person's doing whatever they're doing, you can get caught up in a conspiracy if it's a federal case. Even without physical evidence, all they need is somebody saying, hey, this guy was involved with our situation or our drug dealing or whatever. Little things like that. Now, even if you're not actually getting involved with things, there are plenty of situations where, you know, especially if you're hanging out with older people, you're like a 16-year-old and you're hanging out with 20-year-olds. 20-year-olds really shouldn't be hanging out with 16-year-olds. That in and of itself is a red flag. You know, people with 25, 30 hanging out with a minor, socially and things like that. That alone is a red flag. And a lot of young people feel like, oh, it's cool that the old person wants to be around me. If they're doing negative things, they're drinking, using drugs, and doing stuff like that, it's a red flag that these older people are just allowing this younger person just to hang around. One of the things they'll try to do is, let's say if you're 16 years old and another person, you're hanging out with some 20, 21-year-olds, they'll get involved with something, or they'll get you involved in something. They'll get caught, and they'll say, oh, we want you to take the blame. You're only 16 years old. You won't be charged as an adult. People have said that to younger people before, and guess what? There's been circumstances where that 16-year-old ends up being charged as an adult. It doesn't even have to be extreme as drug dealing or anything like that. Romantically, you gotta ask yourself, why is this older person romantically involved with you, a 16-year-old or a younger person? These are things you gotta learn. You can avoid the problems by just using your head. A lot of times we let our egos get in the way. I'm just warning you guys, if you're a younger person, be very careful who you hang out with. It can have some serious consequences for you, even in ways you don't even realize yet. Just hanging out with the wrong people a lot of times can prevent you from socializing or making friends with the right type of people, because they see you hanging around these shady people and they say, oh no, forget about it. I'm not going to have anything to do with this guy. So be very careful who you trust. Be very careful who you socialize with. There's a reason why people say that. It can change your life. Yeah, it can definitely change your life for the worse. So keep that in mind. All right, guys, share your thoughts. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.